Down. Down. Out. Back. Turn. Up. Out. One cha-cha and pompo. Ugh, I get that part wrong every time. And 6, 10, 7, and 8, and... Good, thank you for shaking it. The shaking. Straight arms. Okay, how do you guys feel about that?
I messed up, but I think you guys were doing it better than me, so.
They were doing a spectacular job. Okay, so there's just a couple of things that we've fixed, that we've already fixed, and even within 1 week, we're already back to before, okay? So, like, straight arms. The arms should be straight. When you punch up to the sky and when you punch out to the side, your arms should be straight both of those times, okay? And then every time you do the high Vs and the low Vs, your arms have to be straight, all the way straight. I know they're fast. On the diagonals, it's too slow and then a double. And some of you on the double, your arms are not getting all the way back in. They're just kind of like this, not all the way straight. And so it should be like back out both times, but your elbow was bent. Okay, and then the last thing that's like, every time after the kick line, after you do the up, out, up, out, up, out, up, out, that's when you do one cha-cha and the palm pose. Every time, that's the part that you guys just stare at each other and go, what's it supposed to be? Oh, palm pose! That's the one part we consistently forget. Okay, really, let's get it in there really good. All right, I'm gonna watch it again. Keep in mind the things I just said. Arms all the way extended. Arms all the way extended. Don't get lazy just because you're at your house. And even though you might not have the most room in the world, you surely have enough space for arms. There's nothing so close to your arms that you can't extend your arms out all the way. Okay, here we go. Starting over. Already the arms.
But I said that.
Down.
Here we go.
Straight, straight.
Let's get loud. Turn the music up, let's do it. Come on, people, let's get loud. Let's get loud. Turn the music up to hear that sound. Let's get loud. Let's get loud. Ain't nobody gotta tell.
Straight arm up and shake it. Straight arm up. the first time. Now it's a T. Now it's a low B. There you go. Everybody in. Okay, so there's two spots in the choreography that I want to work on. The arms were much better that time, especially when I was yelling, arms! You were really, like, ready to have your arms straight. So thank you for that. The diagonals looked great. The diagonal part is one of the cleanest parts, which means it's the most appeasing to my eye. I like to watch that part because the arms are so sharp that I'm like, ooh, look at that, yes. Okay, the two parts in the choreography are... right before the end, you have, it's the combination that we learned at the very, very beginning of this class. It was jazz square, chasse, chasse, kickball change, kickball change. Okay. The jazz squares, for some of you, are not looking like jazz square. It's looking like stomp, 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 stomp in place. You're not doing a jazz square. Your feet aren't actually making a square. So most of you, I can see, like Emma, I can see your feet. Adriana, when you scoot back, I can see your feet. Miranda, I cannot see yours. Will you tilt your camera down? Thank you so much. Okay, so on the jazz square part, Miss Eliza, will you turn around and do the jazz square part from where you are? Okay, so watch as her feet, she's gonna go across with her right foot. She's gonna then step back with her left. She's going to step out to the side on her right, and then she's going to step forward on her left. So the feet are right, left, right, left. Okay? If you cross the wrong foot over first, then your whole jazz square is backwards. You cannot just, like, pick it up in the middle because you're on the wrong foot and your weight's in the wrong place. So everybody stand back from your camera. I want to see you do it with Miss Eliza. It's across with your right foot, across on your right. Now stay there so I can see. I got to get to everybody's feet on their individual cameras. Adriana, scoot back for me, sweetheart. I can't see your feet. A little farther. A little farther. There you go. Good. Stay. Okay. So it's cross over on your right. Then it's take a step back on your left. Step back on your left foot. So now you've got your right foot in front of your left foot and your weight is back there. You're getting ready to pick up your front foot. Pick up your right foot and take it out to the side. Out to the side. Nope. Micah, stop doing your feet crazy because I'm trying to figure out what you're doing, if you're doing it wrong or if you're doing it right. Cross over on your right foot, Micah. Cross over. Now take a step back on your left foot. Take a step back. Yep. Now open it on your right foot. There you go. Stay there. Okay. Now everybody's on the same foot. And then you step forward. Finish it off by stepping forward on your left. So every time you take a step, just like in tap class, if you step, that means your weight is on that foot. Okay, so I'm not saying touch. You're not just putting your foot down and then picking it back up. You're putting all your weight on your foot when you step on it. Okay, and then it should be like you're like rocking back and forth. You step over and your weight's going here. So the only way, the only place it feels like you could go is backwards. And then it feels like, oh, I'm going to open up my foot to the side and then I'm going to come forward. So you should feel like almost like a circular motion as your body goes around in your jazz square. Okay, if you're just putting your foot down and then picking it back up, then that's when you get the extra weird little steps and it looks really silly. Okay, everybody together, that whole step, ready? Five. So it's two jazz squares, chasse, chasse, kickball change, turn in a circle. Okay, here we go on the footwork. Ready? Five, six, seven, and jazz square, chasse, and kickball change, turn in a circle. So it's three steps to turn in a circle. Try to do it in exactly three steps. It's kind of like turn to the corner, turn to the side, turn to the front on that turn in the circle part. Okay, let's try it again. Ready? Same part. Same part. Here we go. From the jazz square. Okay, so you just did the choreography you just did. You did all of the arms, right side, left side, right side, left side. You do the high V towards the middle Ah, that's the high V towards the middle, okay? 5, 6, 7, and jazz square, kickball change. Oh, sorry, chasse, kickball change, turn in a circle. Jazz square, already on the second jazz square, we lost it. We lost it. People are just doing side, 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 side. You're not doing a jazz square. Across with the front foot, then take it back, then out to the side, then to the front.
Miss Amber?
Yes.
I remember we lowered it down from one jazz square so we can make it to our spot in time.
At the end. Okay, so you do it one time. You do jazz square. Is it one jazz square?
I remember you said that too.
You thought it was one, Miranda?
I thought it was one too.
Micah thinks it's one too. Okay, Eliza just did it. Is it one jazz square at the beginning, Miss Eliza? One. Okay, you're right. Thank you for catching that, Emma. That's awesome. Awesome possum. Okay, so she's right. We did change it to one jazz square, then chasse, chasse, kickball change, kickball change. Now, here's the thing about the kickball change. Normally, when you do a kickball change, you're probably facing the front. In other choreography, you do kickball change for a prep and then turn, or kickball change and pose or something, okay? When your foot is to the side, it's very obvious when your foot is not pointed. When you just flop your foot out there, like a dead fish, it's just out there and you just do kickball change, you don't care about what your feet look like. It looks really exactly, thank you, Miss Eliza. It looks really just sloppy. It just looks like you don't care what that choreography is. It doesn't matter to you as much as the straight arms on the diagonal or the high V, okay? Everything is intentional. So even your foot on that kickball change needs to have a meaning, needs to have purpose. So you need to point it when you kick it. All right, let's do it from the top. From the top, we fixed one piece, okay? One piece of the part where I said the choreography is not so clear. That part is one of them. Across, back, side, front, kickball change, turn in a circle, right? Okay, here we go. Nice straight arm so far. Straight, then on that part.
Here we go.
Love the button. Thank you. look so, so, so much better. Miss Eliza, will you put in your mental notes that we need to work on the other part of the choreography that is not my favorite, is the down and up, up and bend.
Okay.
That choreography just, it looks, I think we just don't know what the arm positions are supposed to be. Some of us are in a touchdown. Some of us are in a high V. Some of us are just, our arms are just doing this. We don't really, we really literally don't know. Okay. So that part I want to see fixed next week. But that last time, guys, that was the best I've seen it in a while. Even though you're not all together, I can see all of you dance at the same time on my screen. And together, that was the closest it's been in a long time, especially the part we just cleaned. I could tell you were like really making sure your feet were going across, back, side, front. There's a part of the musical break that happens right there. It's really punctual on that rhythm. That's why it fits so well there. But when we kind of just fake the feet, we don't really know what they are. We just stomp, and hope for the best. It doesn't look nearly as cool. When the music shifts right there and you guys are on that bat, 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 the stomping part, it just hits the music so fantastically. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you 1,000 times for doing that this one time. Hopefully it's in your brain. Hopefully it's in there and it will be in there next week when I see you again. Right? Look at Micah's like, bye. I haven't even said bye yet. She's the wee. She's like, okay, thanks, bye. Get out of here. Anybody have any questions? Miranda?
So I have two questions.
Great, bring them on.
The first thing is, in the kick line, is there four kicks?
Four kicks, you're correct.
Yeah.
All right, anybody else have a question? No? Okay, bye girls. See you in your living room next week.